Hello everyone, welcome to the online learning program. Today we will discuss immobilization for enzymes and cells. So the immobilization is enzyme attached to an inert insoluble material such as calcium arginate, or in another way you can say this is the imprisonment of enzymes with the restricted movement. Now the question arises, why to immobilize? The very first is the reuse efficiency. It leads to the low input cost, then easy product separation. In downstream processing, it's very easy to separate out your product. Then it's a kind of the continuous process when you are using the immobilized enzymes. Then it leads to the stabilization. Yes, there is a two sides of each coin. So in the same way, there are some limitations, there are some constraints. The limitations are the cost of the carrier. The carrier material which is used for the immobilization of the enzyme is usually costlier. Then its activity loss. Sometimes it happens when we are going for the enzyme immobilization, the activity of particular enzyme may go down. Then it changes in the activity because of the active site, availability of the active site, it can change in the activity. And the major constraint is in the mass transfer. As you know, in the bioprocess of any of the product, the bioprocessing leads to the heat and mass transfer. Then why we are considering the immobilization, and what are the different parameters which are to be used in the immobilization? The very first is the carrier. Whatever carrier you are selecting for the immobilization, it must be effective, it must be easy to immobilize, and undoubtedly it must be cost effective and cheaper. The rate and yield of the immobilized enzyme is also considered a major factor. In this, the temperature, pH optima, and the activity of the immobilized enzyme is a major concern. Then standard methods. There must be a standard method which can be reproduced at the industry. That means whatever method you are designing in the lab must be reproduced in the industry as well. Then the optimization. The immobilized enzyme must undergo the optimization for the different parameters. External protein and surface properties are the major concern when you are going for the enzyme immobilization. The next is the protein surface engineering. By using the different spacer, you can go for this protein surface engineering. You can enhance the surface area of the immobilized enzyme. Ultimately, it will lead to the increase in the productivity. Now, the ideal characteristics for the carrier when we are going for choosing the carrier for a particular immobilization, then it must be inert. That means it must not react to the any of the bioprocess product. It must be physically strong and stable so that you can reuse it. Then it must be cost effective. Yes, undoubtedly, because whatever material you are using, it will ultimately increase your cost of production. Then yes, is a reduction in the product inhibition. That means if there is a reduction in the product inhibition, it will lead to the maximum productivity. Then carrier classification. Whatever carrier we are choosing, it is classified according to its chemical or physical properties. The very first is the inorganic material. Inorganic material can be used as a carrier for the enzyme immobilization. Then organic from the natural sources and organic synthetic material. So coming to the inorganic carrier material, these are the having high pressure stability. That means under the high pressures they are stable. But again, there is a constraint. They may undergo the abrasion, ultimately lead to the some undesired properties. The example is commercially available silica dioxide, which is including porous glass, your silica, mineral materials including clays, silite is also called as a diatomous earth, then santonite, bentonite, etc. The organic natural carriers, undoubtedly, these are favorable and compatible with the proteins because they are available naturally. So the example are cellulose derivative, including DE cellulose, CM cellulose, then a class of dextrans, then polysaccharides, which includes your alginate, starch, pectin, chitosan, etc. So here is, you can see the cellulose and the cephadex, which are being used as a organic natural carrier for the immobilization. The next is organic synthetic carriers. These are high chemical and the mechanical stability. That means their performance over other career is more, but the constraint is they are very expensive. So the example is polystyrene. You can see here the polystyrene, then polyvinyl acetate, acrylic polymers like polyacrylate is there, amberlite is there, euperdite is there. So a class of different organic synthetic materials are there which can be used as an enzyme immobilization. Then coming to the type of enzyme immobilization, what are the different kind of the enzyme immobilization? So enzyme immobilization is divided into two major categories, where in one we are immobilizing on the carriers. In the second, the enzyme is included in a particular carrier. It can be the soluble one. Now in immobilization in the carrier, the cross-linking is there. This is the best example of the enzyme immobilization which is used, and the standard methods are also designed for the cross-linking of the enzymes. Then binding to the carrier. Binding to the carrier includes both physical and the chemical interactions. The very first is adsorption, next is the ionic binding, next is the complexation, the formation of the particle complex, and then binding to the carrier, then covalent bonding. That means the covalent bonds are created between the enzymes and the carrier material. In inclusions, we include the encapsulation in alginate beads such as, and the ultrafiltration systems, few membranes are being used which are harboring the enzymes, and these are used in the continuous system. The cross-linking is the first option for the immobilization. In this, the soluble enzymes are being used, and glutaldehyde with lysine residue is the most favorable compound for cross-linking of the enzymes. Then you can form the crystals of the enzymes. This is cross-linked enzyme crystals, CLEC. Then aggregates, cross-linked enzyme aggregation. Then imprinted molecules like cross-linked enzyme, cross-linked imprinted proteins. So here is an example. You can say the glutaldehyde is there, and then it is, the enzyme is cross-linked with the help of the glutaldehyde. Then inclusion in the polymeric network. This is also one of the best method for the whole cell immobilization. Although we are discussing the enzyme immobilization, in our next we will discuss the whole cell immobilization. So the polymeric network is best for the whole cell immobilization, although it is also used for the enzyme immobilization. Now, what is the major constraint when we are using the polymeric network? The major constraint is the diameter of the enzyme. The diameter of enzyme is very small, and the enzyme may leak from the polymeric network. To avoid this, that we can go first with the cross-linking or binding with the nanoparticle. The enzyme is first cross-linked or binded with the nanoparticle, and after that it is used in the polymeric network. Next is the binding to the porous material. This is the most favorable enzyme immobilization. This is the standard method. This is standardized in the lab conditions, and the industries are also using for this. It all depends on the capacity of the carrier. In this, the carrier is the main material, you can say, or you can say main parameter which we have to consider, and the different characteristics which we have to consider for the carriers are chemical. It includes its hydrophobicity, chemical and microbial stability. Then mechanical is resistant to the pressure, its elasticity, its compressibility. Then is the general characteristics we have to consider is the food and pharma grade and cost. It must not produce any toxic compound when any bioprocess is going on. Then coming to the adsorption. Adsorption is binding to the carrier. It involves the physical binding of the enzyme on the surface of the carrier matrix, and carrier may be inorganic, organic, or organic synthetic molecule. The process of adsorption involves the weak interactions including van der Waals or the hydrogen bond. The carrier which are being used are the silica, bentonite, cellulose, and the enzyme which are used for binding to the carrier at industrial level are catalase and invertase. So here you can see this is a particular carrier, and enzyme are adsorbed on this by van der Waals interaction or the formation of the hydrogen bond. Now coming to the covalent bonding. Covalent bond is the more stronger, and it is irreversible in nature when we are considering it in enzyme immobilization. Based on the binding of the enzymes and water insoluble carriers by covalent bond. the functional group that may used as a binding between our amino group, carboxyl group, sorry. The functional group that may take part in this binding are the amino group, carboxyl group, sulfuric group, hydroxyl group, and by this a covalent bond is created between the carrier material and the enzyme, and care must be taken that the enzyme's active site must be open, otherwise the activity loss will occur in the cross linking. So these are the few industrial enzymes which are being used by the different industries using the cross linking, like your glucose isomerase. This is most widely used, and the different companies Novozyme, Gencor, UOP, CPC, Nagase were used this. And the methods are cross linking by the glutaldehyde, enzyme linked to ion exchange with the polystyrene, then enzyme to ceramic alumina, then GI on ion exchanger. Then next to it is a beta galactosidase, which is a lactase, and the Hokkaido sugar company is using this. Then Ashicam, DSM and Ricordia are using penicillin acylase. So likewise, the different industries are using different enzyme immobilization method to cut down the cost of input for the production. Now coming to the immobilization of microorganism and the whole cells. Now, the immobilization of the whole cell can be defined as the physical confinement or localization of intact cells to a certain region of the space without loss of desired biological activity. Yes, this is the most considered parameters when we are going for the whole cell immobilization. The cell or the microorganism must not lose its biological activity. Now, what are the desirable characters for the whole cell immobilization? There must be high cell mass loading capacity. That means whatever carrier we are choosing or whatever method we are choosing, it must involve the maximum number of the cells so that our productivity can be increased. Then affords easy access to the nutrient media. Now, if there is a limited access to the nutrient media, it will lead to the low productivity. The particular molecule which can be a precursor or which is to be biotransformed, if it is not available to the microorganism, it will lead to the low production. Then yes, undoubtedly it must be simple and it must not produce any toxic compound during the bioprocess. It must afford high surface to volume ratio. This high surface, as you are increasing the surface area of a particular microorganism, it will lead to the more productivity. It facilitates optimum mass transfer. Then yes, the material you are using, whether it is a carrier or any of the solution you are using for the cross linking, it must be sterilizable and reusable. Then it must facilitate easy separation of the cells from the media so that the downstream processing can be easier and the separation of the product will be more. And it must suitable for the conventional reactors as well as the cell suspension and the anchorage. Anchorage are the used for the mammalian cells where we are producing the antibodies and the your vaccines. And it should be biocompatible for the animal cells. Like whatever method you are designing, it must not restrict it to the microbial cells. It must be favorable for the animal cells so that its application will be more, and it should be economical viable. That means it must be cheaper as compared to the overall bioprocess. Now, the advantages of the whole cell immobilization. The very first is there is no need for the enzyme isolation. There is no need for the purification. That means a lot of money and the labor can be saved by using the whole cell immobilization. Then it includes a multi-enzyme complex reactions. That means you need not to add a number of the enzyme in a particular bioprocess. It includes all the enzymes which are available in a particular cell. Then cofactor regeneration in the native system is a kind of the natural system. It's a kind of the natural bioprocess. So the cofactor regeneration is easy in this, and there is the application of anchorage dependent cells, like for the production of antibodies, production of vaccines. This is the most suitable for the mammalian cells. Yes, there are limitations as well. The limitations are insufficient stability and having the low resistance. Then mass transfer limitation. The heat or the energy created or produced during the bioprocess is not transferred naturally, or because it is having the limited movement, it is restricted to a particular carrier. Then few side reactions also increases. The product which is formed may be degraded by the whole cells by producing the different other enzymes. Then byproduct from lysis of the cells, and there are chances that the secondary metabolites including the toxins, they can be produced. Hence the pharma grade product may hamper here. Then in most of the cases the low productivity is there, although it can be reproduced or reused. Few fundamental aspects related to the whole cell immobilization. Undoubtedly there is change in the microenvironment of the microorganisms, so they may behave differently. Again, the mass transfer affect the substrate and the product formation. Yes, it can lead to the enhanced production or it may suppress. So we have to optimize for the maximum production accordingly. So yes, there is effective diffusion coefficient. It ranges from 50% to 100% of all the free solutions, like in ionotropic gels, diffusion close to that in the water. Then mass transfer reduced with the growth and increased the biofilm thickness. The immobilized cell physiology also changed its growth and reproduction. Then specific productivity, like in case of the whole cell immobilization of the Saccharomyces cerevisiae, it will increase 40% to 50% in the alcohol production. So in this case it's a beneficial one. Then differences of intracellular pH and the higher resistance. So these are the different methods for the whole cell immobilization: adsorption, adhesion, covalent bonding, cross-linking, encapsulation and inclusion. All these methods are standardized in the lab conditions, but most of the industries, they are using adsorption, adhesion, encapsulation and inclusion. There is limited application of covalent and cross-linking. Yes, these are used in the mammalian cells for the production of antibodies and the vaccines. Although, why this is happening? Because these both are more expensive as compared to the others. So immobilization by the adsorption. Adsorption and growth of microorganism or surface is a natural phenomena. Why natural phenomena? Because if you can see, there are stones where the microbial biofilm is formed naturally. Like in case of the trickling water filter, naturally the biofilm is formed on the clay, the microbial biofilm is being produced. Your plant material, pathogens, they are forming the biofilm. Then your teeth enamel, teeth like cavities are being formed by the microorganisms, so they are forming the biofilm on the teeth. Then the plastic like polyurethane forms. The example of this is, since 1823 the vinegar production is in use, and in vinegar production adsorption of acetobacter on the wood chips are being used, like acetators are being used, or generators are being used. So even today more than 60 million reactors or trickling generators are used, which are converting 90% of the alcohol into the acetic acid. Then curled beechwood filling, which is having more than 20 years of the life, is also a good example of the adsorption. Then manufacturing of the beer, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, it is immobilized on cyan porous silica particles. Then polystyrene carrier coated with DEA cellulose is also an example of the wine production or beer production. Then antibodies, therapeutic proteins and vaccines like gelatin and collagen are being used. Cross-linked dextran and cellulose are being used. Glass is used and polystyrene are used where the mammalian cells are anchored on the surface, and then further antibodies and the vaccines are being produced. Then immobilization by the adhesion. Adhesion is the next to the adsorption. Now the very first step in the adhesion is the adsorption. The microorganism is adsorbed on a particle surface. Thereafter it starts secreting the exopolysaccharides, and after that there is the adhesion, and then the initial growth is there, and after that a biofilm is formed. And it is having very much use in the industries. You can take the example of sewage treatment plant. Like in Chaudhary Charan Singh Haryana Agriculture University, we are having sewage treatment plant, which is following on the based on the MBBR technology. This moving bed biofilm bioreactor is supporting the biofilm formation, and this is a very good example of the addition of the wholesale immobilization. This is again an example of the entrapment in the matrix, and the enzyme used is the transaminase. The E. coli cells which are exhibiting the transaminase activity. Transaminase is used for the production of the amino acids. Then these are mixed with the silica microsphere, and the silica solution is formed, and the E. coli cells, they are entrapped in the silica material, and then further they can use in the batch reactor or the continuous reactor. In the batch reaction, the sec vials are used, and then in continuous flow, the packed bed reactor is being used. So this, the next is most widely used wholesale immobilization method is the formation of the alginate beads with the whole cell. In this case, the microorganisms are mixed with the sodium alginate solution. After that, by using the syringe, it is transferred into the cold calcium chloride solution, and it forms the beads of calcium alginate. And these calcium alginate beads are active, and then further we can use in the different fermentation systems. So these are the few examples of the wholesale immobilization, like for the production of the ethanol, butanol, isolation. In most of the cases, you can see here the alginate is being used. So most widely used immobilization method for the wholesale is the production of the whole alginate beads. Then polyacrylamide is also used. Then carrageenan is also used. Carrageenan is a kind of the seaweed. Then cellulite is also used, which is diatomous earth. So here we are stopping with the immobilization of the wholesale and the enzymes. If you have any query, you can write me, as my email is given in the introductory page, and I'll take care of all of your queries. And in the next, we will discuss the application of wholesale immobilization and enzyme immobilization in the industries. Thank you very much. Thank you for listening carefully.